we're told to let g of x equal f of x raised to the fifth power, and then if f of 4 equals 3 and f prime of 4 equals negative 2, we want to find g prime of 4. This question is testing to see whether we recognize that g of x is a composite function, and therefore to find g prime of x, we need to apply the chain rule of differentiation. G of x is a composite function because the inner function is f of x, and the outer function is the power function raising this to the fifth power. The basic idea of the chain rule is to find the derivative of a composite function, we find the derivative of the outer function, and multiply by the derivative of the inner function. Or if we look at the provided derivative formula given here, this is the power rule with the chain rule built in, where u is the inner function. Notice how the derivative is a product, where this first factor is the derivative of the outer function, and the second factor, u prime, is the derivative of the inner function. So if it's helpful, looking back at g of x, we can let u equal f of x, since f of x is the inner function, so we can think of this as finding the derivative of u to the fifth, which means g prime of x would be equal to 5 times u to the fourth times u prime, or 5 times f of x raised to the fourth times f prime of x. So if we want to find g prime of 4, we'll substitute 4 for x. Well, f of 4 is equal to 3, so we'd have 5 times 3 to the 4th times f prime of 4, which is equal to negative 2. Well, 3 to the 4th is equal to 81. 81 times 5 is equal to 405. 405 times negative 2 is equal to negative 810. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.